In this video, we are going to discuss about creating threads or defining threads. We can create a thread mainly in two ways. The first way is by extending thread class. The second way is by implementing runnable interface. So totally we have two ways in order to create the threads. First one by extending thread class, second one by implementing runnable interface. Thread class and runnable interfaces are present in a package called lang package. So first let's see the first one, how we can create a thread by extending the thread class. So here we are using a java.lang package. Why? Because here we are using a predefined class called thread class. So thread class is present in lang package. Here totally we have four steps are there. The first step is create a user defined thread class by extending thread. So this is the first step. So what is the first step? Create a user defined thread class by extending thread class. So we know how to define derived class. So class space, let us assume that name of the class is mythread space. Here we are extending what? Thread class. So extends thread. Okay, so this is the first step. So creating a class by extending thread class. And the second step is we have to provide the definition for our thread. We have to provide the functionality for the thread. So for that purpose we are overriding run method. So run method is present in the thread class, but let us assume that we are not satisfied with the run method of thread class. So that's why we are overriding that method. So this is the second method. This is the second step. So what is the second step? Provide the definition for mythread class. Provide the definition for the thread by overriding run method. Okay, so actually run method is present in which class? Thread class. But as a child class we are not satisfied with our parent class definition. So that's why we are providing our own definition by overriding run method. Okay, so let's see the body of the run method. So for int I is equal to 0, I less than 10, I plus plus, system.out.println child thread. So we are printing child thread message how many times? 10 times. So this is called as child thread. Okay, child thread or user defined thread. Okay, and this is our main program. Why? Because main method is present in this class. So this is our main class. So class test public static void main string args. Here the third step is create an object for the thread class. Okay, so already class is declared, so we have to create an instantiation. We have to create an object for the thread class. So my thread, let us assume the name of the object is t. So my thread t is equal to new my thread. So this is the third step. And the fourth step is call the run method using start method. Okay, so t dot start method. Here we are using this start method in order to call the run method. Okay, there is no need to use the run method here. So here in thread class we have a method called start method. So by invoking this object, so t dot start, we can call the run method of the thread class. So whenever the statement is executed, then the control goes to the run method of my thread class. Okay, so what is the body there? For int I is equal to 0, 0 is less than 10, condition is to child thread. So child thread message will be printed how many times? Child thread message will be printed 10 times. Okay, next, once this run method execution is over, control comes to the main method. So after the main method we have a for loop. So this is nothing but main thread. Here we have a main method. This main method is called as main thread. So every Java program contains one thread, that is main thread. Okay, so in main thread we are calling our child thread with the help of this method. So t dot start method will calls the child method, the child thread. Okay, so this is nothing but what? Main thread body, main thread duty. So for int, why? Because here we are using this for loop in which thread? In main thread. So for int I is equal to 0, I less than 10, I plus plus, system dot out dot println main thread. So this message, main thread message, will also be printed 10 times. So after displaying child thread, so what will happen? Main thread message will be printed 10 times. So this is the output for this program. So first, child thread will be printed 10 times. Next main thread will be printed 10 times. Okay. So this is nothing but our child thread body. So this is nothing but our main thread body. Okay. So here how many steps are there? Totally we have 4 steps. The first step is create a class by extending thread class. Second step is provide the functionality or definition for the thread by overriding run method. Third step is create an object for the above class. Fourth step is call the start method so that our run method will be called. Let's see the second approach. The second approach is by implementing runnable interface. So runnable is an interface which is present in lang package. Okay. So import space java.lang.*. Next, class, let name of the class is myThread, implements runnable. We know that whenever we are implementing an interface, we have to use a keyword called implements. Whereas here thread is a class, so we have to use a keyword called extends. Next here, runnable interface contains an abstract method called run method. So whenever a class is implementing that interface, that class has to provide the definition for the run method. Okay. So runnable is an interface which contains an abstract method called run method. So if a class is implementing runnable interface, then that class has to provide the definition for run method. Okay. So this is the first step, same as the first one. Okay. So create a class, but by implementing runnable interface. Whereas here by extending thread class. So create a class by implementing runnable interface. And the second step is provide the body for the thread, provide the functionality, provide the logic for the thread by writing the definition for the run method. So by implementing run method. So public void run, same body here. So for int I is equal to 0, I less than 10, I plus plus, system.out.println child thread. So that the child thread will be displayed how many times? 10 times. Okay. So this is nothing but the body of our thread. Okay. So this is the second step. Next, we know that the execution will start from the main method. So this is nothing but main class, class test. So what is the name of this program? Test.java. Here also the name of the program is test.java. So public static void main string args. So first we have to create an object for this class. So my thread t1 is equal to new my thread. But here the problem is this run method is present in thread class. Runnable interface doesn't contain run method. Run method is present in which class? Run method is present in the thread class. So runnable interface doesn't know what is run method. So for that purpose, we have to create an object for the thread class here. So this is our third step. So what is the third step? Create an object for the above class. Create an object for the user defined thread class. And the fourth step is create an object for thread class. And here we need to pass this runnable interface object as the argument. Okay. So thread t2 is equal to new thread of, here what is the object we created here? t1. So we have to pass this as the argument. Okay. We have to pass this t1 as the argument now. So next we know that run method is present in thread class. So now we have a thread object. So that is the fifth step. So call the start method. So t2.start. So whenever start method is called, then what will happen? The run method will be executed. The run method of the thread class will be executed. So this will be executed now. So what is the message here? Child thread. So how many times this message will be printed? This message will be printed 10 times. Okay. And next, this thread execution is over. Next control comes to the next statement, for loop. So this is nothing but the body of our main thread. So for int I is equal to 0, I less than 10, I plus plus, system.out.println main thread. So this main thread will also be executed how many times? 10 times. Okay. So this is nothing but the body of the main thread. This is nothing but the body of our user defined thread. So totally we have how many steps are there? 5 steps. So what is the first step? Create a thread class by implementing runnable interface. Second step, provide the logic for thread by implementing run method. Next, the third step, create an object for the above class. Fourth step, create an object for thread class by passing this runnable object as the parameter. Okay. Next, fifth step, call the start method using the object so that our run method of the class will be executed. So these are the two ways in which we can create or we can define the threads.